Welcome on back to another episode of Sky Saga Infinite Isles. Still in Alpha 5, and you may notice a lot of things have changed down here. Primarily that we don't have our smelting system down here anymore, or our massive storage. Keystone Oven is what that's called. Got moved over as well, and there's a few extra chests over there. But you may notice on the minimap a bunch of still chest icons, and those got moved on up here. I figured if we were going to have a proper fortress ruins, if you will, which, by the way, I have rebuilt most of this, I believe. I think there might be a spot or two I need to fix up and whatnot, but everything here should be rebuilt. Torches everywhere and whatnot. We'll have to check this place out at night, though. It really does look awesome. I know what I gotta do. There's a few windows in these towers that are normally there that I did not cover. These here, by the way, are the large lizardmen chests that we kind of looked at last episode. These take a lot of stone to make, like, holy crap. With this bottom one, I moved all my wood stuff in. The top one has all of the leather dyes and other fabric stuff. This one's got some miscellaneous materials in it, along with that one. This here is one of my blocked chests. So you got the sky stone, the dirt, the snow, the gravel, which, by the way, we'll be using some of the gravel in this episode. Clay, got a chicken behind me making sound, a sand, the earth stone, coral stone, rose stone? Bloodstone. Windstone, and floodstone. The same goes for the top one. You got some miscellaneous blocks and materials, as well as a row for bloomstone. My food chest is still down below, along with the keystone stuff and some miscellaneous armor pieces and whatnot. Over here, I don't have... Oh, my ores and stuff are also still down below. Over here is where the ores and whatnot will be going. I have yet to move everything, though. My intentions with these chests is having two metal types per chest, primarily because of how many I can get of a certain one, and whatever I have the least of is probably going to take the last two slots, and whatever I have the most of is probably going to take the first three rows. So that's how I'm going to be divvying those up. And I have been very busy. Let's see, what key was it? It was that. I'm at Settler Guild Rank 10, along with Explorer Guild Rank 10. I still only have the Ruins Island for the jungle, as well as this one. I got some photos. Edit profile, there we go. There are sigils you can get, which you may have noticed these in the past couple of episodes over players' heads. Yeah, there are quite a few you can unlock. You start with the Meandros here. The rest of these I've unlocked over time. I've also unlocked two titles by hitting rank 10 in the Explorer and Settlers Guild, I believe. Crafter came from the Settler, and Pathfinder came from the Explorer, I believe. I've chosen Pathfinder as my title for now, so I'm Pathfinder Calvin Shin. So, some of the goals for this episode... Also, I almost forgot. I got these last episode, like before that episode got recorded, and I totally forgot about them. I don't know what these do. All it tells me in about is use it with extreme caution. I will need Gladiator Rank 0 and a Metal Anvil in order to craft these. Again, no idea what they do. They sound very interesting, but we'll have to take a look at those at another point. Because the time is not now. Now, with all that stuff moved out from under here, this place is very, very empty looking. It really does. It looks very, very empty. So I want to actually work a bit on looking at some of the aesthetics of this game. Since we have not really been able to take a look at that, we've obviously been able to see some stuff while we're exploring, but we can't pick any of that stuff up. So I want to be able to make fences or ladders. Well, there are fences in here too, I believe, somewhere. I don't know where they are off the top of my head. You got the benches, wooden beds, small peasants' wooden bed, even. Flags, barrels, shelving, stuff like that. stuff that'll make the place feel more like at home. But this is... Maybe we can get a better shot of everything if we go up here. Oh, and I also want to add stuff like up here and whatnot, like flags and whatnot. Just make it look all fancy and like it's supposed to be an actual castle build, rather than some sort of large blue structure with white outlines around doorways and this plus thing in the middle. This is what it looks like actually from up above. If we go to photo mode. Okay, so we can actually go to photo mode, but it doesn't really do much for my UI. Yeah, I really like this. Also, I'm going to try to explore these islands in this episode as well. Yeah. I think that's everything that I wish to mention now. What do I have in this chest over here? Oh, I have those miscellaneous title scrolls and recipes and schedules that I have. I put those extra things in that chest there. That's what I was doing with that chest. But we are going to need quite a bit of wood here, and I think for now we are going to use ground wood. Let's see, we have the ability to make some tables, small bench. You know what, let's just go ahead and craft up one of these, one of each. I believe if we were to place them, we can't pick them back up, I don't think, so we actually do have to break them. That's part of the reason why I want to use ground wood. Speaking of, what does it take to make one of those again? Metal bolt, metal rod, and 4 wood planks. You know what? Let's just head on down. I was going to make the metal bolts and rod just because I could, but all of my ores and stuff are still in here, so I may as well grab all that stuff right now and just bring it up. That was the wrong button. Meanwhile, could also make another workbench so we can craft more things at once. Having two forges is definitely a good thing to have, in my opinion. And probably even having two workbenches probably would help a lot as well. Let's go ahead and put this one here. Why not? Alright, let's see. Oh, we can also make some metal, wood barrels. Specifically a... Let's go ahead and get that started. Let's go ahead and put the rest of this material away. Along with those. Alright, let's see. We have the copper we can make, and the small bench is the other thing we have to make. Alright, so let's see. With this basic bench, it's apparently 3 wide. Good to know. Let's see. We could have it right here. Okay, we can actually pick that up. While that stuff is still crafting, we can actually work on what the gravel path will be as well. The gravel path will be around here that leads from the airship into the building itself. And thankfully, sand and gravel does not obey physics like it does in Minecraft. So, floating blocks are not an issue. Which, honestly, part of me kind of wishes they had some sort of gravity system in this game. But considering we are in the sky, I suppose gravity would be less, but I can't imagine it would be nil. Like how most of this actually is demonstrated to us. Plus, we actually get to see how this lines up. Is this actually too wide, or is it 3? I actually don't know. It is 3, and that was a misplace. Alright, I'm gonna put the airship right here in this 3x3 spot once we grab the gravel. For this table, we'll put on down below. I want to grab the gravel chips in this chest. Gonna put those there just because we can. Alright. I really hate the prediction of moving up in this game, since you can auto walk up blocks, but if you notice, the spot I auto walk up is about a block and a half away. So if I move to the left or the right here, I end up kind of skipping over the hole. I honestly find that annoying. I really do. It's nice to make things flow together, but that's about it. When you're trying to build, I know I can press control so I don't move off the level of platform I'm on. Like if I'm here, I don't, and I'm pressing control, I don't go off on each side. But I don't know, I feel like they need to work on their prediction model for going up blocks. There we go. Alright. So now we have a gravel path. By the way, this dirt block will grow into grass when I leave and come back. Apparently that's all it takes for them to grow back into grass, if they are able to, I believe. As long as they're not underground. I believe that's how it works. Let's see, we got the coffer, we got the table, and we got a chair. Let's go. Let's see. So let's see, how does this chair get placed? So it faces your direction. Put this here along with the table, and what is this? A coffer. I don't know what a coffer is. It's about here. Let's actually check this out. So, what are you? Just a larger table? That's what you kind of look like. Yeah? Kind of looks like a larger table. Alright, and we got a small bench. Actually, it looks pretty nice. I like it. Can even stand on it. Now, can we put a coffer on top of it? We can. And now can I have a floating coffer? I can. Alrighty. Well, I gotta keep that in mind. Let's see. We could have a barrel there. And let's put the barrel maybe in this corner. The bench and the coffer. Let's leave that there for now. Let's go ahead and see what we have else available for us to make, even if I don't have the materials on me to make it. Let's see, the flags. A basic but colorful flag. We should try to make one of these as well. So it takes two fabric sheets, a wood rod, and metal weights. I'm going to assume the wood rods would change the color of the rod, obviously. The metal weight's probably going to change the color of the thing at the bottom. And the color of the fabric sheets is probably going to change the flag color. Let's go ahead and use red for that. We got ground wood on us. And wait, what was it? Metal weight. Couldn't remember if it was metal weight or metal plate that I said. Alright, so we should be able to make a flag now. Yeah, that definitely does change the color of the flag. That's going to take 30 seconds, that is fine. Actually, what else can we... We can make a wood stove. I'm going to assume the wood stove is actually based on that metal weight color. Let me see about that. Yeah, so if we wanted a gold or a sun steel stove, we could. Let's just go with the sky iron, though. Primarily because that looks more natural, in my opinion. I know this game is on about naturalness, but it's gonna look the best to me, in my opinion. Let's also put this gravel and the dirt back. Alright, we got a flag. Let's see. Okay, so it's 3 tall and it goes out 2 more. Does that... It depends on which way I'm facing, right? Yeah, okay, so it always goes to the left. It always goes to the left of where I'm facing. Alright. With that in mind, we can go ahead and head on up to the top. Top. Let's go and pick this up. We need a new spot for these torches. Let's put one there, one there. Oh, it's nighttime, actually. This is actually what the place looks like at night. There's some lighting issues. As you can tell, like the ones being off in the far distance is not being rendered. Or if I turn just right, it's not showing the lights. I didn't have this issue initially when I was first ending the last episode, and I think it's because of how many lights there are. I think there's probably a limit on how many lights can actually show up right now, and it might actually be a setting that I have to change locally to get them all to show and pop up. But regardless, with not all of them in, I still highly like how this looks to do. But let's go ahead and take a look at that flag. Do I like how the flag is there? I do. So that means I need another 4, 8, 12, 15. 15 of those flags. I don't know if we have the materials for all of that. How many fabric sheets to take? 2? That's not bad. I don't have enough for 15 more, though. But we can go ahead and get those crafting up here. Alright, so there's 3 more. While those are going, let's go ahead and run back up here. Pick up that flag. We should be able to dismantle it. We do. So we'll get 3 components out of this if we were to dismantle it later on and decide we don't like it anymore. I am very much okay with that. That'll work just fine. Alrighty. Is there anything else on... Oh, right. The stove. Let's put that down. Okay, so that actually gives off light. We've seen these before while exploring. Let's head on down. So essentially the upper area is going to be the crafting area and whatnot, and down here is pretty much going to be like a living quarters. Let's see. Could probably put the wood stove there. Let's go ahead and pick up this table and chair. Actually, I don't like it in the corner anymore. Let's see, probably here. Yeah, make the food over here. We get a prep table in. When we're done, we can come over here and eat. Obviously, there's no eating in the game that is required while you're on your island outside of healing, but you know, gotta roleplay every once in a while, right? Do I like the bench or the copper here more? I think the bench. The coffer reminds me more of a bedroom kind of item. Alright, I believe all those flags have been completed. Yep. Oh, and they don't stack. Good to know. Alright, let's head on up and we can go ahead and place them all down. Take a look at how this seems. By the way, there are a lot more... More decor items that I don't have. Damn it. But. Got it. may have taken full damage from that, but I got it. But yeah, there's a lot more decor items that I have yet to unlock. So we are just touching like the very tip of the iceberg on this. Damn. There we go. I got that one just fine. Let's see, how does that look? You know what, the red actually goes well with this, especially at night. Very much okay with this. We still need to put the torches back, though. Oh, and you not being able to put a torch in the block you're standing at is honestly quite annoying. And it's even weird that you are able to place a torch and it ends up just kind of floating in midair. Got it. We got one more flag left, apparently. What? That's not where I wanted to. Nope. Not quite. Third time's a charm. Aha! Third time's a charm. Alright. Good, good. I'll have to work on that as well. We got a small square frame that we could also make. We need paper for that. Let's see, we got plenty of paper. We could make quite a few of these. I don't know if these actually change at all, depending on... does the image on it change at all, I wonder? If you create it out of different wood by chance? Wait. What does it take for that? It's wood rods, right? 12 of them. What's over here? Alright, let's see. I imagine the frame itself would change. Yeah, the frame itself changes, but not, not anything else. Alright. So let's see. Let's go ahead and put this down. Alright, it's the image we saw. Okay, it's always going to be that image. That's alright. Got no complaints about that. Alright, let's see. We can go ahead and put it here. Yeah? Yeah? Alright. What if there's a too wide painting that we can get at some point? Because I think that would fit over there better. Alright, this small peasant's wooden bed requires wood planks, fabric sheets, and feathers. I don't know if I have enough feathers for that. I do not. That's unfortunate. Alright, so we need to be looking out on feathers later on. Roof thatch, nah. Fire pits, metal rods, and 6-foot planks. I got plenty of planks on me. I can actually combine those stacks. 12 metal rods, huh? Alright, let's see. Where is that at? Go ahead and craft one of these on up. Meanwhile, while waiting on that to finish, let's see. Large bamboo wall hanging. We need vine rope. I don't know if we have vine rope. Length of tough fibrous jungle vine. It is crafted at a stone forge. Vine rope. Okay, so we can actually make vine rope. Good. Now, how about this, though? Let's see. This is a 2x2 thing. It's fairly large. It's a lot larger than I thought it would be. So, put it there. Let's actually put it out here. It's kind of like a fire pit on the outside the gates, if you will. Works for me. The sheep is sleeping. Let's not disturb the sheep. Lanterns. We need candles for those. Speaking of candles, the candles require wax, and the only wax I'm ever able to find is orange. The other colors I have not been able to find. I've tried. I've tried. Finding like different colored hives for the bees, because that's where I've been getting wax from. Which I believe one of the episodes where I win getting wax from a beehive. And it's always been orange. In the cold area, it's orange. In the forest, it's orange. In the jungle, it's orange. And in the desert, it is orange. I don't know where to get the other colors of wax from. Oh, we can also make a door, right? I recently learned this recipe, actually. We need 8 wood planks and a metal plate on that. We'll have to keep that in mind. Is there anything else here? Got wooden barricade. Simple wood barricade. The carved Yeti statue. Interesting. Small rustic shrine. Fancy upholstered chair. Decorative jewel of metal plates, fabric sheets, and wood planks. We got the planks. We need 4 fabric sheets, 4 metal plates, and a decorative jewel. The decorative jewels and stuff I have over here. So I'm gonna take the blue ones. I think actually we have a red theme kind of going on with the flags. We could use red or even green. Green would even be an option. What else did it take? Okay, so we got those. Let's see. If we want red and no, not red and blue. I need to look again. How many fabric sheets? Just 4. Okay. 4. So we could actually make it out of black. Black goes well with every color anyway. So let's see. That would look like that. The metal plates. I wonder if it's going. It's probably going to change the top, huh? I'd imagine. Actually, before I use the ores to make that, we should have the metal plates down here. We do. Like, we have so many metal plates out here for sun steel. I want the top of it to be gold, and I want the rest of it probably to be wormwood, perhaps, which we needed planks for, I believe. I got wormwood rods, but not planks. There's planks. Alright, we should be able to make this now. Yeah, we're gonna be able to make one of these. If we wanted another one, we would have to have another 10 planks, which we can go ahead and put these back into plank form. And not have enough, damn. Alright. Perfectly fine with that, perfectly fine with that. We'll have to deal with one for now. Let's go ahead and put some of this stuff away, though. Alrighty. So we got that. Let's see how this looks. Oh! It was very fancy. That's interesting that they have 2 in the back. I like how that looks. This would be a good, like throne room kind of chair, if you ask me, but for the time being, since we don't exactly have access to all of that, it's kind of right there, right next to the table. It kind of makes look that makes the table look very inadequate, like it's not fancy enough. Yeah, that table really needs to be more fancy. Do we have a fancier table option by chance? Let's see. Rope fence, gong. Okay, I actually want to make a gong at some point. I love gongs, I really do. Ornate some kind of middle. What is this? Hanging jeweled lamp. I think I want to make one of those as well. Take 6 decorative jewels and 6 crystals and 4 metal rods. I didn't see any better option in there for that at all. Words, trying to come up with words there. Was not able to come up with words. We'll take some of these crystals and kind of look at how they change what it appears as. And metal rods, alright. Okay, so that's what the brown looks like. There's green. Okay, so I see what the decorative, the jewels do. The crystals change the color of the actual lamp itself, it looks like. Man, we need 6 decorative jewels. That's a lot of jewels. It's the wrong chest. So we can literally make an all yellow one. With the materials that we have at the moment. And that's what that looks like. That is a lot of yellow. That is a lot of yellow. How do we make these? It takes 2 crystals and it will be made at a stone forge. Okay. And these will make this, which is the crushed jewels, so it takes 2 of them as well. I'm curious. How many does it take to dismantle this? We just need 1, and we'll receive 1 black crystal, or 1 crystal in return. Huh. So we can make 1 out of black. Yeah, we could have a black interior and something else for the outside. Let's go into it. Alright, so there's 6 of them. If I can get to the right tab. I see. So that is a thing. I really need to be careful with this because I don't have any more black crystals except for the potential for, or the guarantee of 2 more from the crushed black jewels, and I honestly don't see black jewels of any sort that often. They're a very rare item, even though it says common in the tooltip there. Yeah, black crystal uncommon in this particular case. Large black glittering crystal often found in caves. Yeah, I have never found one. I've never found a single black crystal growing in a, or glowing in a cave. If we go for the yellow theme, since we have that chair down there. Actually, we used green for that, didn't we? What did we use down here for the chair? I don't even remember anymore. It was black and blue, it looks like. Wait, no, that's green. It's gotta be green. No, we use blue. It has a different color tint down here. Let's go ahead and make it blue then. Question is, do I use Sky Iron or the Sun Steel? The Sun Steel would go well with the top of the chair, and the blue would go well with the gems chosen for the chair. However, the Sky Iron rods make it look more metal looking and less fancy. Lamps aren't meant to be a central focus point in. That sound, by the way, is still way too loud. Lamps aren't meant to be a central point of focus in our room, so let's go ahead and go with the Mist Sky Iron on that. Did we discover something at some point? Oh, right, we discovered the black variant of the crystal. Okay. Alright, so we got that. Let's see, how do you look? You are very, very large. You are a lot larger than I thought it would be. That is perfectly fine, though, because we can... let's see. Put a torch. I would want that lower. That is some weird lighting. But again, alpha game. Alpha 5, specifically Alpha 5.3. I expect issues like this. I like the light, I really do. And honestly, I'm curious to know if we're going off the episode here, because looking at the time, we've gone on for about half an hour. How much light does this actually give? That is a quite substantial amount of light off of that one lamp. And it looks like the light itself is actually blue. That is interesting. I wonder if the color of the crystal chosen changes the light color. I'm so curious right now. I actually wish to try this. I'm also curious to know if the glass changes the coloration at all. Let's go ahead and make an all green one. We have plenty of green. I can get plenty of green. It's not a problem. It's gonna take 30 seconds. Hello, sheep. Oh, okay, we can actually push you guys around. Alright. I'll have to keep that in mind. We have some animal pens outside with the sheep and chickens of this island. No, don't go back inside. No, I'm back inside. Go away. Stop. Stop it, sheep. Alright. Tie on back down one final time. Just gonna pick this lamp up. Exchange it out for that one. Okay, so it actually does dictate which color it is. Meaning if we had a white jeweled one, it would be producing a white light. And I believe white jewels are white crystals even a thing? Crafting. Crystal. There are other colors I've yet to find, so I'm going to assume white is indeed a color of crystal. Wait, is that? No, that's not the image of the last one we made. Thought for a moment it was, but no, it's just the default one that they give you. Okay. So I do like this. I do like this a lot. Another question I have now is if we have two of them. What happens with the lighting on that? And like, is one of these brighter than the other? If I take these torches away, is that one darker than this one because this one has the color black in it? And it honestly kind of looks that way. Could also be the color as well, because that's blue and the walls are blue. That might be showing less, whereas this one's green and I can see it on the blue very vividly. Okay. That's interesting. But looking at the time, we are going to have to call this an episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this break from adventuring and looking at the decorational options and the aesthetics of the game that we have available to us at the moment. We have to essentially adventure more and explore and kill monsters in order to get more recipes unlocked, which is honestly part of the reason why I haven't been recording every single thing I've been doing since Alpha 5 came out, because it literally is the same kind of adventures over and over again, with very little variation in what actually is going on. The names may be different, but the mobs and whatnot, they're all the same. We'll have to check out a jungle, though, since we haven't been able to in great detail. I don't believe we've been to a jungle. Yeah, we haven't been to a jungle yet, I don't believe. But yeah, it'll have to happen another time. Hope you guys enjoyed this longer episode. If you did, remember to leave it a like and subscribe to the channel for more Sky Saga and other video games that I do on the channel. This place is definitely coming together. But we'll have to continue our adventures in the next episode. Until then, chicken away. No. Take it easy.